Balakand chapter 1. We are going to continue with the description of Lord Rama's beautiful qualities as given by sage Narada to sage Valmiki. So far we have completed 12 descriptions of Rama's qualities and 18 descriptions of Rama's physical appearance. Now we are going to continue with his qualities. In verse 12, dharmagnya satya sandah cha prajanam cha hite rata yashasvi jnana sampanna shuchi vashya samadhiman. He is pious and firm in his vows. He is ever intent on doing good to his subjects. He is illustrious, wise and pure at heart. He is obedient to his elders and is ever meditating on the means of protecting those who take refuge in him. So these are the various qualities that are described by sage Narada in this verse. So let's go through each and every one of them in great detail. The 13th description of Lord Rama's quality is dharmagnya. This happens to be one of the first qualities that sage Valmiki asks, gunavan kashya viryavan dharmaknishya. So this is the third quality that sage Valmiki asks sage Narada, if that person exists who possesses all these qualities. Out of those 16 different qualities, dharmaknya is the third. And over here we see that in Narada's reply, it is the 13th quality. So dharmagnya means the knower of rectitude, the knower of dharma, the knower of religious principles. And what is Lord Rama's dharma? Actually, the Supreme Lord has no dharma except to protect his devotees. Therefore, the weak and the oppressed find in him a ready and fearless champion. We have also seen that Rama makes sure that he does the right thing for all the people concerned. So, killing the Shudra Shambhuka may seem that it is not right, but Rama has to make sure that the dharma of the Yuga is being followed. Rama has to make sure that all the citizens are taken care of. And therefore, he kills Shambhuka because Shambhuka's actions had an adverse effect on the life of a little Brahmana boy. Therefore, Rama kills Shambhuka under the advisement of sage Narada himself so that the Brahmin boy is revived. And dharma is very interesting. And dharma is very difficult for any ordinary person to follow. But both Valmiki and sage Narada say that Rama is dharmagnya, the one who knows dharma. There is another place where it may seem that it is not dharma, but actually it is. This is during the departure of Lord Rama, Sita and Lakshmana into the forest. As we all know, they rode on the chariot of King Dashrata. The charioteer was Dashrata's very close friend and confidant, the minister Sumantra. And Sumantra began to ride the horses very fast. But the king kept on shouting, "Oh Rama, please stop, please stop." And Rama kept asking Sumantra, "Go on, go on, go on." So Sumantra is now caught between two different people, two different orders, and both of them seemed right. Should he pause at the behest of his king, Dashrata, and accede to the wishes of all the Ayodhyavasis? Or should he go on and listen to Lord Rama, who is his beloved Lord? So whom should he listen to? Then at that time Rama says, "Oh Sumantra, please continue forward And when you return, if the king asks why you didn't stop the chariot, just tell him that in the noise you couldn't hear his orders. It may seem as if this is not correct. Sumantra very clearly heard the king's orders to stop, and yet Rama is asking him not to stop and to basically lie and say that he could not hear the order. But no, Rama does not lie. Rama is very truthful. Rama is very honest. So what does he say? When you return, if the king asks you, tell him that in the noise you could not hear at all. Because King Dashrata had to fulfill the duties of a king and make sure that Rama goes into the forest, because he promised his wife, his citizen, that Rama will go to the forest. Of course, King Dashrata did not know what he was promising, and yet it was his beholden duty to make sure that the boons he gave Kaikeyi will follow through. And therefore, Rama says, if the king asks you, he doesn't say, if my father asks you. He says, if the king asks you, tell him that you could not hear. Because he knows, because Lord Rama knows that it was not the king that followed into the streets of Ayodhya begging Rama to return. It was the heart of a fond father. And therefore, Rama is subtly reminding King Dashrata that he has to fulfill the duties of a king at this point. King Dashrata obviously fulfilled the duties of a father by not being able to live without his beloved son. And why does he say that, oh, in the noise I could not hear anything? Why does he ask Sumantra to say this? It's because anything else is just basic noise. If you're not doing your proper duty, if something is preventing you from doing your duty, it is just noise. So therefore, even though it seems as if Rama is basically asking Sumantra to lie, no. He is taking care of Dashrata's dharma. He's taking care of Sumantra's dharma. Why? Because he is dharmajna. The one who knows dharma. Dharma is very difficult for us to understand. We have only one true dharma, and that is to obey the orders of the Supreme Lord. We don't have any other dharma. That is the constitutional position of every living entity. But Rama is dharmajna. He knows everyone's dharma. He knows everything. Therefore, the position of dharmajna is not given to any ordinary person. It is given only to the Supreme Lord and his incarnations or his true representatives. Now, let's go on to the 14th description of Lord Rama's qualities, and that is Satya Sandha. Rama's resolves are all accomplished. He is bidden by the truth. He is bound by the truth. He is always truthful. He is firm in his vows. So that is Satya Sandha. So this corresponds to Valmiki's question of Satya Vakyo and Drudha Vrata. So Satya Vakya means always honest in his speech, and Drudha Vrata means firm in his vows. So Satya Sandho is a combination of these two qualities, Satya Vakya and Drudha Vrata. And Satya Sandha means that he is so bidden by the truth that he is never going to budge out of it. We saw that he goes to the forest for 14 years. And not even his beloved brother Bharata could help break Rama's resolve to go through with his promise to his father, King Dashrata, and his mother, Kaikeyi, to reside in the forest for 14 years. So Rama is extremely honest. Rama promises the sages of Dandakaranya that he is going to destroy all the demons that pollute their sacrificial altars and basically wreak havoc. And Rama goes through this elaborate plan of being separated from his beloved wife Sita and giving opportunities for the Vanaras to serve him and going through this huge battle. Why? Because he is extremely honest. He is firm in his truth. He promised to protect the Devatas as Lord Vishnu. He promised to protect the Devatas from the onslaughts of Ravana and his followers. He promised to protect the sages from Ravana and his followers. And he just goes through his promise no matter the personal cost. And this is what we see in Lord Rama. He's extremely firm in his vows and he's extremely honest. So if Rama says that he is going to protect us, we need to have the utmost faith that that is the truth, the absolute truth. The 15th description of Lord Rama's quality is Prajanam Hite Rata. This corresponds to Valmiki's question, Sarva Bhuteshu Hitaha. The one who is the best benefactor of all the living entities. Over here, Sage Narada says that Rama is Prajanam Hite Ratha. The one whose concern is always the welfare of his subjects. He is ever intent upon the highest good of all beings. Why does Sage Narada say this? Why? Because Lord Rama is Sukhridam Sarvabhutanam, the best benefactor of all the living entities. This is mentioned in Bhagavad Gita 5:29. And Sage Narada says, Prajanam. Praja means his subjects, his people, his children, Hite Ratha, the one who is the best benefactor. So what does Rama do? Rama makes sure that everyone gets the fair deal. Rama, the Supreme Lord, is equal to everyone. This is mentioned in the first chapter of the 7th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. Sage Narada says this to King Yudhishthira, that the Lord is equal to everyone. And over here, Sage Narada is saying the same thing to Sage Valmiki, that Rama is the best benefactor of all the living entities, of all his subjects. The subjects in Valmiki Ramayana are Ayodhyavasis, the ones who want to be ruled by Lord Rama. There were few who did not want Rama's rule. They went against Rama, and what happened to them? They were destroyed. Of course, even when he destroys demons, Rama proves his kindness that we will see over and over again in the various chapters of Valmiki Ramayana. But we have got to know that we should accept Rama's rule. The people of Ayodhya were willing to be chastised by Rama. They were willing to go through deep ends for the sake of pleasing Rama. When Rama went to the forest, the citizens of Ayodhya followed him till the banks of river Tamsa, and Rama decided that he did not want his devotees, his bhaktas, his Ayodhyavasis to suffer with him in the forest. And so he leaves them on the bank of river Tamsa and he goes off further deep down into the forest. But after 11,000 years of the rule, when Rama decides to go back to the spiritual world, the people of Ayodhya say, oh Rama, we don't care if you're going to the forest. We don't care if you're going to the ocean or the river. We cannot spend a second without you. Oh Rama, please take us with you. Rama sees the pure devotion that the people have for him. He knows that the level of affection that they have for him was the same, if not more, than what it was 11,000 years ago. Therefore, he says, okay, my dear friends, I'm going to take all of you with me to my world. And every single living entity, not just human beings, But the movable and the immovable, plants, animals, birds, worms, every living entity in Ayodhya was given a place in the spiritual world because they followed Rama. So Rama knows what is beneficial for us. And we need to be willing to be ruled by Rama. Rama has full sway over whatever he wants to do with us. There is another example. Bharata wanted Rama to return to Ayodhya. So prior to going to Chitrakuta to ask Rama to return to Ayodhya, he meets sage Bharadvaja. And Bharadvaja says, "Oh Bharata, the exile of Rama is going to prove very beneficial to the devatas, the danavas and the rishis. The entire mankind is going to benefit from Rama's exile." So Rama knew certain promises that King Dashrata gave to Mother Kaikeyi's father prior to their wedding, which perhaps even King Dashrata has forgotten, but Rama hasn't. And he reminds Bharata that his father was perfectly justified in giving Bharata the kingdom. And therefore, when Rama stays in the forest for 14 years, he is fulfilling pretty much all the promises that Dashrata has made. So he is making sure that Dashrata is always considered to be truthful. He goes into the forest because he wants to provide benediction to the vanaras and the sages and so many other living entities in the forest. But he also ensures that Ayodhya is protected. That's the reason why he gives his sandals to Bharata. And he gives the sandals to such a great devotee as Bharata, who will not and does not do a single task without taking the permission of the sandals of Rama. So the Ayodhyavasis were protected. His devotees in Dandakaranya were protected. They were given beautiful service opportunities. And there were so many sages who received moksha after they served Lord Rama. So Rama is prajanam hite rata because he is the best benefactor of all living entities. We will continue with the rest of the descriptions in the next verse.